In the 1980s, the Space Shuttle is the new, exciting chapter in space travel. Then Challenger explodes. This is the story of that flight, the human story behind a technological disaster. Krista McAuliffe, a teacher, will be the first ordinary citizen in space. Roger Beaujolais, an engineer, knows Challenger has a problem and tries to stop the launch.
You! Listen to me! Now!
And Richard Feynman, an eccentric genius, is part of the commission that investigates the Challenger disaster. Challenger puts the entire space program itself on trial and casts a long shadow over one of man's greatest dreams, the conquest of space. Kennedy Space Center. Space Shuttle Challenger prepares to launch into a cold winter sky.
T-minus 10, 9, 8, 7, 6. We have main engine start. 4, 3, 2, 1. And liftoff. Liftoff of the 25th Space Shuttle mission, and it is cleared to tower.
It's throttling up. Three engines now at 104%.
Challenger, go at throttle up.
Roger, go at throttle up.
15 seconds, velocity 2,900 feet per second. 800 miles, and range distance 700 miles. Flight controllers here looking very carefully at the situation. Obviously a major malfunction.
President Reagan cancels his State of the Union address to speak to a shocked world.
The crew of the Space Shuttle Challenger honored us for the manner in which they lived their lives. We will never forget them, nor the last time we saw them, this morning, as they prepared for their journey and waved goodbye, and slipped the surly bonds of Earth to touch the face of God.
The loss of Challenger leaves the country in mourning. Seven astronauts are dead. Among them, a woman who has deeply touched the heart of the nation. Krista McAuliffe, a high school teacher and winner of NASA's Teacher in Space contest. This morning, she was to become the first ordinary citizen to travel into space. Her dream now lies shattered on the ocean floor. The shuttle is the most complex machine ever built. It has over 2 million separate components. It is now essential to find out exactly which of its thousands of systems catastrophically failed. Within days, President Reagan sets up an inquiry, named the Rogers Commission after its chairman, William Rogers.
I would like to call the commission to order, please.
9 days after the disaster, they begin to call key witnesses.
My name is Roger Beaujolais, and I'm in the structures section. And I've been involved basically since coming to Thiokol some 5.5 years ago.
The presidential commission is made up of industry experts, scientists, and politicians, with one exception. Richard Feynman, a Nobel Prize-winning physicist. Feynman will play a key role in the investigation.
No, I was not.
The commission will explain the reason behind the Challenger explosion and the loss of seven astronauts. The story of the Challenger mission starts almost 2 years before launch in the town of Concord, New Hampshire. Krista McAuliffe teaches at Concord High School. She's popular. Her enthusiasm fires up her students. Like all the best teachers, Krista brings her subject to life. Krista's expertise is social history, and she's especially interested in the diaries of ordinary women in the 1800s who moved west with their families across America. She works these stories into her course called The American Woman.
Now, history isn't just about politicians or generals or explorers. It's also about the wives who kept their families together while the men were off exploring. Everyone makes history, and we are going to be reading about and listening to the people who don't usually get written about. I'm going to be asking more of the...
Krista is a child of the space race and has grown up with a new pioneering dream. When she was just 13, she witnessed John Glenn, the first American to orbit the Earth. She's been fascinated with space ever since. On April 13, 1984, shuttle mission STS-41C is returning to Earth. That morning, Krista's family notices she's more interested in the newscast than breakfast. For Krista's generation, space is still a dream. So far, no civilians have gone into space. Perhaps for her young children, Scott and Caroline, space travel will eventually be a reality. NASA's stated aim is that the space shuttle will make space travel routine. So far, it has only been for an elite corps of professional astronauts. What Krista doesn't know is that NASA is planning a competition to send America's first ordinary citizen into space. The announcement comes 4 months later, when Krista and her husband Steve stop for some burgers on their way home.
Here we go. Don't say I never buy you dinner.
But why do they only ever serve finger foods at these formal things?
Well, I won't drag you along next time.
You can't turn out to date your wife.
Well, I know you don't like these things.
Well, you do the same for me.
A radio announcement catches her attention.
Today I'm directing NASA to begin a search in all of our elementary and secondary schools and to choose as the first citizen passenger in the history of our space program, one of America's finest, a teacher.
Oh, I was thinking we could get away this weekend, go to the coast.
Yeah, sure.
That was pretty interesting when you said teacher in space. It's too bad I don't know any teachers. You should try out.
Yeah. I should try out.
Krista will delay sending in her application to the last minute, but hearing the president that night has already sealed her fate. The space shuttle program is in full swing. 1 year from now, NASA plans to launch Challenger. At the engineering plant of Morton Thiokol, a NASA contractor in Utah, Roger Beaujolais and his colleagues watch as Discovery mission STS-51C comes safely back to Earth. The engineers that work on the shuttle know that it is not a perfect machine. Like any new technology, it has problems. From cracks in turbine blades to faulty heat exchangers.
Good.
The problems are not sufficiently serious to stop the shuttle from flying. Still, every safe landing is a relief. Morton Thiokol manufactures the solid rocket boosters for NASA. The rocket boosters are strapped to each side of the shuttle's main liquid fuel tank and provide the explosive force to lift the spacecraft off the ground.